You're listening to Nuestra Gente with Linda Parra.
Amigos oyentes, digan todos ustedes muy buenas tardes y bienvenidos una vez más a Nuestra Gente Radio Show con Linda Parra. Estamos acá en vivo. Estamos, por supuesto, llevándoles otra interesante entrevista en el día de hoy para todos ustedes, mis amigos, en esta jornada de entrevistas con candidatos a estas elecciones del 2020, del General Election 2020. Así que hoy estamos con Paula Hick-Hudson. Welcome to the show again.
Thank you for inviting me. I'm so excited to be here in your studio. Last time I was someplace else, but now we're in your studio, which is really awesome.
And before you were the mayor, so now you're on the state label.
Yes,
so we're gonna talk about that.
Okay.
Alrighty. So, mis amigos, estamos acá en Nuestra Gente Radio Show con la que fue nuestra alcalde en la ciudad de Toledo y ahora está sirviendo en la casa del estado de Ohio. Ahora está en el nivel del estado de Ohio. Okay, we had a few questions for her, and we're going to know a little bit more about Paula Hick-Hudson. So, tell us about yourself.
Well, as you know, I'm currently the district representative for Ohio House District 44, which includes most of the city of Toledo. So, my district starts from the river, going west to Holland, Sylvania, south of 475, doesn't have Ottawa Hills, doesn't have West Toledo, then it goes far south. Unfortunately, I don't have this part of the city, but I go south and pick up like around Airport Highway. But what I do is I represent City Council Districts 1 and District 4. So if you can think about those geographically, and also I'm the minority whip, which means I'm the third person in leadership in the Ohio House Democratic Caucus, which is a pretty big deal at being the first first-term legislator going down there. I think part of it was because I was the former mayor for the city of Toledo.
Yeah, that was great.
Yeah, it is, because I get a chance to listen in.
And now you're going to go up.
We'll see about that. I really want to do more for our district, so we'll see what happens.
Yes.
And if that's part of what can do it, then that's what I'll do.
Yeah. That's what we need. We need people to represent us at the state level, too. So I had a question. What is the most stressful, now that you're talking about your job, what is the most stressful part about working at the Ohio House of Representatives?
Some of my colleagues don't look at their jobs as representing the entire state, that they only represent their one portion or their one area, and they don't see how by doing something that may be positive for them might be negative for the next district. And I'll give an example. We just received, Toledo received $8.7 million less than what they would have received because one legislator decided that he didn't like the formula that was used to give the CARES money, the COVID relief money from the feds to the states to local governments. And so Toledo lost $8.7 million. I don't believe that good government is only about what I get for me, but it's about what we can do for everybody.
For everybody, helping others.
Yeah.
So estamos conversando con Paula Hick-Hudson. Ella fue la alcalde de acá de Toledo y ahora es miembro de la Casa del Estado de Ohio. Nos representa en la ciudad de Toledo. Nos estaba conversando que ella pelea por la ciudad de Toledo para recibir más fondos. Se le negaron, bajaron ingresos a la ciudad de Toledo en cuanto a ayuda para la pandemia del COVID-19. Y es una de las cosas que a ella le frustra cuando tiene que defender su ciudad y hay otras personas que no lo hacen, que prefieren otras, para ellos, otras alternativas, otras prioridades. Cuando en Toledo hay muchas, we had a lot of priorities here in Toledo, so we needed that money.
Absolutely, absolutely. And that's the part that made it so hard, because one of my colleagues who represents the poorest district in the state stood up and said, I need to understand why we changed the formula, because the other two disbursements was based upon this one formula. And so why did we change it at the last minute? And he said, because it wasn't fair and it didn't represent his people.
Well, but you had a people to represent, that's what you fight for.
Absolutely. Yeah. And so he believes, and I just think that we have to come together and work on issues that affects and benefits us all, not I'm not going to help you because it doesn't help me. We have to help each other.
Oh, yes. Everybody.
Yes.
It's a service. We
Absolutely.
Are serving.
Absolutely.
We have to serve everybody.
Absolutely. I believe in being a public servant,
mm-hmm.
which means that I work for the people,
yeah.
and I make sure that it's that we do what's best we can. But he did it at, you know, he just did it because he could.
Okay, we need to talk
yeah.
about him later.
Yes, we need to pray. We need to pray for him and his soul.
Yes, we need to talk about him later.
Yeah.
Así que continuamos conversando, mis amigos, acá con Paula Hick Hudson, quien fue la alcalde de la ciudad de Toledo anteriormente y ahora nos representa en un nivel del estado de Ohio actualmente. Nos comentó sobre eso, una de las frustraciones que ella tiene en cuanto se está trabajando allá en la casa del estado de Ohio y es la que una de estas por las cuales que ella estuvo peleando fue para que la ciudad de Toledo recibiera más fondos para el COVID-19 acá, pero se lo negaron por una persona que se opuso totalmente. Vamos, we're going to do the second question. So now we talk about what is the more stressful,
mm-hmm.
but what is do you like most about your job?
I think what I like most about my job is that I'm at a different level where I can see how if I can tell the Toledo story, we can get more things to benefit us. Just as I said about this one guy, I've been able to talk to departments and to bring information back to Toledo and talk about ways that we can put Toledo on the map in Columbus so that people won't just think about Cleveland, Columbus, or Cincinnati.
I know, the three
C's.
The
three
C's.
Yeah, but part of the reason they talk about the three C's is because
we're going to say CCT.
Yeah, no, we should say TCCC.
Okay, great.
Yeah, and so that's, to me, is the exciting part, to tell our story and to talk about what's happening here and make sure that when legislation is passed, that it's being done with the idea and from the vantage point of what happens up here. Like, for example, with the lake and H2 Ohio, I wanted to make sure that the money that was going to be spent was really going to be spent to help us and not go into different departments and things like that. And then also to keep monitoring that. You know, secondly, you know, we have a horrible issue with infant mortality. So working with some of my colleagues in Columbus, we're talking about, again, what's happening in Toledo and what we need in order to really address those issues. And so that, to me, is, you know, if I have any purpose, the purpose is to really be that voice and to really talk about what's happening.
Good.
Yeah.
Let me do it in Spanish
okay.
ahora.
Okay, sure.
Ella nos está comentando, la pregunta fue, ¿qué es lo que más le gusta de su trabajo? De su trabajo nos comenta que ser de Toledo y representar a la ciudad de Toledo y pelear por todos los beneficios que pueda recibir la ciudad de Toledo en el nivel del estado. Y one of the things that I would like to mention is that you were the mayor, so
mm-hmm.
you know what are the problems,
yes.
right? You know what are the needs in
yes.
this city.
And
you were close to those.
And that's one of the biggest things because I talk about finances. The city of Toledo has been losing money from the state in so many different ways over so many years because of this whole mindset to really squeeze and strangle cities for townships. I say there's enough for everyone. Let's work together so that while, you know, like you have a township that might need some resources, but also you have a city that needs even more resources. So when our tax dollars go to Columbus, most of that money should come back to us, but
mm-hmm.
it doesn't. It stays there or it goes someplace else. That's wrong.
Si nos comenta ella que estando ahora en el nivel del estado, ella ve cómo hay tanto dinero que se puede ofrecer a la ciudad de Toledo y que se puede entregar a los diferentes programas acá de la ciudad de Toledo, pero que no, que van a otras ciudades que las priorizan primero que la ciudad de Toledo. Hay muchas necesidades. Los taxes no se regresan por completo, ni siquiera en lo más mínimo para la ciudad de Toledo. Se reparten en otras ciudades que ella considera que no es lógico y que deberíamos se necesita de trabajar más en equipo para tratar de que esos taxes que vienen de una ciudad regresen a esa ciudad para programas también. That I say, those taxes that
mm-hmm.
the state receive from Toledo, they should come back for services to the city that they come from.
Absolutely. And work in such a
because
way.
Because where the citizens are paid for.
Yes.
So we are here. So we need those services.
So we have to do a better job.
So who else there with you representing Toledo? Because I think I'm going to go there and join your team and then be a fighter too there, because we need that. We need more voices for Toledo.
And here's what I'm, and one of the things that you didn't ask me this question, but what I can, what I need is for people to, number one, say what's going on in the State House. Tell us what's happening. I'm going to get your email address so I can send you stuff from my office. Mm-hmm. But then also, I need citizens to say, I don't like this, or I do like this, and I need you to fight for this or fight for that or whatever.
Send me that.
I will, so that, because that's how...
We need to hear that, those voices.
That's absolutely correct, because when the people speak, mm-hmm. your elected people will listen. Mm-hmm. And so if we don't ever talk, if we don't ever speak, if we don't vote, if we don't do the census...
Your voice.
Yeah. So I believe that that's the best thing that we can do. So whether you become a state legislator or you send an email every time you think about something, that gives me more power, more strength to say I have a citizen that reached out to me about this issue, and here's what they said.
Yeah,
and that goes
you
a
need to
way.
Show those.
Yes.
Say, look, we have people that is in this, and they need to hear from us, and then you
Absolutely.
Guys need to provide what they need.
Absolutely, and that means coming to Columbus.
You should open a newsletter.
Well, I do. I have a monthly newsletter.
Yeah.
And so I'll just make sure that you're on it.
Yeah. Please do, and then we need to share all that information with people that listen to Toledo, because we need people that represent Toledo and fight for us, and we need to support that.
Yes,
and we
absolutely.
Need to make that noise.
Absolutely.
Know? So, I'm going to say en español.
I know.
Mis amigos, estamos aquí conversando con Paula Hickson. Ella es miembro de la Casa del Estado en Ohio. Nos representa en Toledo desde el Estado. Y fue anteriormente el alcalde de acá. Estuvimos conversando, tenemos una larga conversación sobre que ella, se necesitan escuchar las voces de Toledo, que los ciudadanos de Toledo peleen por esos recursos que le pertenecen a nuestra ciudad. Se discuten muchísimas situaciones en el nivel del Estado y no se llega a la voz. ¿Por qué? Porque no hay ciudadanos que reclaman, que pelean por esos, por ese dinero que la ciudad necesita. Entonces, ella nos comenta que hay muchísimas cosas que se pueden promover y ofrecer a la comunidad en cuanto a información para que tengan conocimiento de lo que está sucediendo, del dinero que está disponible, y que podamos nosotros levantar nuestras voces y decir ese dinero le pertenece a la ciudad de Toledo y nosotros queremos recibirlo. Entonces, es lo que ella le hizo una sugerencia de ofrecernos información para compartir con ustedes sobre qué es lo que se está discutiendo y qué es lo que necesitamos saber aquí en Toledo. You need to share with us what is going on there, because we need to know here in
Absolutely.
Toledo. Yeah.
And I will definitely
and
do that.
As a former mayor, you
Absolutely.
Have the biggest reason to say, I was mayor and I fought for my city. So,
yes.
And they, and my citizens need to know all this.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Absolutely. We do a monthly newsletter. We send it out via email. And so I just need people to sign on. And it's my email is rep44@ohiohouse.gov. And that's simple as that. So just send me an email and we'll put you on the list. October 6th, early vote starts, and then election day is November 3rd. Have a plan and work your plan. And then once you figure out how and when you're going to vote, ask someone else to tell you what their plan is and help them vote, because voting is so important.
Yep.
That's my last words.
Okay. All right. So ella nos está diciendo, nos invita a toda la comunidad y a todos los ciudadanos que se registren para votar, porque es importante votar en estas elecciones. Recuerden que lo hemos mencionado también anteriormente con nuestro invitado we had a Secretary of State, Fred LaRose, here, and he offered that information also, que ustedes tienen que votar en estas elecciones. La fecha límite para registrarse for the registration is on October 5th. El 5 de octubre es el último día que ustedes tienen para registrarse si no están registrados para votar, y pueden votar temprano el día siguiente. And I would like to thank you for joining
thank
us
you.
Today.
Thank you so much for having me. And I'll come back anytime you want me.
Yeah.
Thank
come
you.
Back with all those newsletters and
yes.
we will inform the community, because that's our job.
Absolutely.
The community informed.
Absolutely. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Thank you.
Mis amigos, nos estamos viendo en la próxima oportunidad, cuando tendremos otra interesante entrevista para todos ustedes y tengan conocimiento de todos los candidatos que están corriendo para estas elecciones del 2020. Muy importante que ustedes tengan el conocimiento de esto. Así que les quiero mucho y los veo en la próxima oportunidad. Les habló Linda Parra. Chao.
Bye.